Mentor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents The True Story of Pocahontas, The Other Side of History, by Dr. Linwood Little Bear Custalow and Angela L. Daniel Silver Star. Narrated by Rainey Fields. Prayer to the Great Spirit Ahone. Ahone, 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 aho. O good and great spirit, you who are all knowledgeable, all wise, and all understanding, grant me your wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to present the full Mattaponi tribal history in conjunction with written history and research and truth, that it may not cast blame or be offensive, but in a way that it may be enlightening to all who read this book. May the true history of the past acknowledge mistakes, aggressions, deceits, prejudices, wrongful intents, greed, and injustices. May we present our history in love, withholding nothing, that we may see the past as a helpful tool to make the changes that we need in order to walk together in harmony and in love and justice. Let us borrow each other's moccasins so that we may see each other's points of view. Let us walk in the present and not in the past, that we may make this day and all of our future days a better place for your creation. May you see us as pleasing from your great moccasins. Aho. Dr. Linwood Little Bear Custalow, eldest son of the late Chief Daniel Webster Little Eagle Custalow. Sinekamaka, 1607 to 1613. Our land was called Sinekamaka in the Powhatan language. The English called it Virginia Britannia or Virginia. The map shows the approximate location of some of the prominent Powhatan villages and English colonist settlements from 1607 to 1613. Present-day Virginia. The Powhatan chiefdom once held an alliance of 32-plus tribes. Today, there are only 8 state-recognized tribes in Virginia, 5 of which were part of the Powhatan chiefdom during the late 17th century: Pamunkey, Mattaponi, Dansamond, Rappahannock, and Chickahominy. The current-day Eastern Chickahominy tribe split from the Chickahominy and Pamunkey tribes. The Upper Mattaponi tribe is a newly formed tribe organized in the 1980s. None of the Virginia tribes have been granted federal recognition, and some have not yet received state recognition, such as the Powhatan Potawatomi tribe. Only the Pamunkey and the Mattaponi tribes have been able to retain reservation land. They have also maintained an unbroken peace treaty with the Commonwealth of Virginia since 1646. This map shows the approximate location of 8 remaining Eastern Virginian tribes that were related to the Powhatan chiefdom. Foreword. Why tell the story now? Letter from Mattaponi Chief Carl Lone Eagle Custalow. I don't see a time when this history was more needed for my people than now. Our oral history has been kept hidden for so long, it's dying. People have not looked through our cultural lens at history. It's time to look at the other side of history, the sacred history of the Mattaponi. I write this letter while watching the rain fall outside my home on the reservation. I look at the Mattaponi River below, and I see things not seen by most people. I live on the river, and my people live here. We are the people of the river. The river and the reservation are our life. Interwoven with our daily lives, the river has always been a source of deep honor and self-preservation. Life for our ancestors was a harsh struggle. Our land and food sources were taken from us. Later, laws were passed severely limiting our rights, banishing us from public schools. We were forced to live outside mainstream activities and culture. During the 1940s, 50s, and all the many moons back to the first English settlement at Jamestown, we would not have considered telling the true story of Pocahontas. Even my father knew he could not tell our history. people were not open to hearing it. Deeply embedded, our experiences, our memories, and our dreams have lain secret for almost 400 years. From the earliest period in Mattaponi history, we were able to thrive, develop, and later survive the arrival and settlement of our land because of the Mattaponi River. Today, the Mattaponi River, with its vast acres of wetlands, endangered fish, and wildlife, is threatened by a proposed dam, the King William Reservoir Dam. Our very survival is once again threatened. If the river is destroyed, we have nowhere else to go. We have no alternative but to fight the construction of this proposed dam. Today, we are not alone. Others have stepped forward to support us in our fight to save the river. For the first time, through mutual respect, people have become emotionally, if not physically, invested in our survival. People want to hear the truth. They are open to it. It is time to tell our oral history. The True Story of Pocahontas will help everyone to gain a sense of our cultural history, learn lessons not taught in school, and discover the deep historical connections between tribes as well as with other communities. As you read this book, look at us through our eyes. Reading my brother's words, sensing the excitement in his voice, the way he describes our tribe's past with such spirit and courage, his humility about his own position as recorder and protector of our history, and even his own physical condition, assure me that now is the time to tell the other side of history, the Mattaponi side. No one knows our history better than Lynn Little Bear. His passion for learning our oral history has brought unusual insights to it. Lynn Little Bear has stayed the course when many would have faltered. Angela Silverstar has made it possible for all things once safeguarded in Lynn's mind and heart to be recorded and preserved for future generations. For this, I will be forever grateful. This small book honors not only Pocahontas, but all Mattaponi. With warm regards, I am Mattaponi Chief Carl Lone Eagle Custalow. Preface. Who we are. The surviving Powhatan priest decided that the maintenance of Powhatan tribal history was important because history tells us who we are. Dr. Linwood Little Bear Custalow. Dr. Linwood Little Bear Custalow's Teachers of the Mattaponi Sacred Oral History. Travel in all four directions as the four winds blow and teach the history of our people. Dr. Linwood Little Bear Custalow's grandfather, Mattaponi Chief George Thundercloud F. Custalow Sr., 1865 to 1949. Dr. Linwood Little Bear Custalow's family members who carry aspects of Mattaponi sacred oral history. Wingapo Natapawa Mattaponi Anianiowa. Welcome, my good friend. I am from the Mattaponi. The Powhatan history of Pocahontas has been orally passed down from generation to generation. You have not read this story before. This is the first written history of Pocahontas by her own people. It is vastly different from the history you have been taught from school, novels, and movies. Because the Powhatan people did not have a written language, our knowledge, religious and secular, was kept in the hearts and minds of a chosen few, the priests, or Kiakros, who dedicated their lives to learning. There were many Kiakros in our society, at least one or more in each tribe, who maintained, preserved, and imparted knowledge, preserving the history of the particular tribe in which they served. The Powhatan Kiakros were like living libraries. The Kiakros of the Uttamasic Temple were the highest order to serve the Powhatan nation. Knowing how important Kiakros were to the Powhatan society, the English sought to annihilate them. As the Powhatan society began to collapse after the War of 1644 to 1646, toward the middle of the 17th century, the Kiakros of the Powhatan nation elected to remain stealth under the Mattaponi tribe. the Mattaponi chief sought to conceal the remaining Powhatan Kiakros among our people from the English. The Pamunkey tribe was busy maintaining secular relations for the Powhatan tribes with the English. This meant that the Mattaponi tribe had to remain clandestine until the last decade of the 19th century. Of all the possible types of knowledge to maintain, history is considered the most important. Our history tells us who we are. We have passed this knowledge on through the Kiakros, then through the chiefs, for generations. It is sacred to us. I have spent my life learning our sacred oral history. Today, I share that responsibility by passing on the knowledge of the tribe's oral history to Angela L. Daniel Silverstar, my co-author. Together, we are recording the sacred oral history of the Mattaponi for future generations to know. We invite you into our world that you might begin to know us for who we are. Dr. Linwood Little Bear Custalow, historian of the Mattaponi Indian Tribe, Williamsburg, Virginia, 2004. Preface: The Other Side of History. Tell the true story of Pocahontas. I hear this plea when I walk among Pocahontas' people. The Other Side of History, the true story of Pocahontas, is the story of Pocahontas as told by her own people. Buried under fame and myth, the true story of Pocahontas, according to our Powhatan descendants, has never been published before. It has been hidden for nearly 400 years within the Mattaponi tribe, out of fear of violent retribution if it was told publicly. At the same time, it is about more than one person, Pocahontas. It is about the Powhatan people entering an era of immense changes. The Other Side of History incorporates the sacred oral history of the Mattaponi. Maintaining this history has been a long-term tribal effort. The history is not from the insight or opinion of one person. Dr. Linwood Little Bear Custalow has been learning the Mattaponi sacred oral history since childhood from late chiefs of the Mattaponi tribe, including his father, Webster Little Eagle Custalow, his uncle Otha T. O. T. Custalow, and his grandfather, Chief George Thundercloud F. Custalow. Those that have gone before him made it possible to pass this history on. In addition, other Mattaponi confirm Lynn Little Bear's rendition, including Shirley Little Dove Custalow McGowan and Edith Whitefeather Custalow Coons. Oral history, tradition, does not comprise made-up stories. In the 17th century and before, history was maintained by the Kiakros Powhatan priests. It was passed down from generation to generation in a very strict and disciplined manner to maintain accuracy. During the starvation period of the late 1600s into the 1800s, the population of the Powhatan people, as well as the number of Kiakros, rapidly declined. Up until the early 1900s, a Kiakro held the position of what is called an assistant chief today. The Other Side of History also provides readers with the Powhatan interpretation of events documented in 17th century English writings. This book is an attempt by the Mattaponi to document in a written format their sacred history that has been maintained orally for centuries. There are many benefits to a written tradition. It can reach a vast number of people, and it is also less vulnerable to being lost. Still, there are attributes of oral traditions that are not obtainable in a written format. For example, the written word seems inadequate in capturing the spirit and emotions that poured forth from Lynn Little Bear's telling of the sacred history of his people. In the oral tellings, people of the past, such as Pocahontas and her father, Chief Powhatan Wahaseneca, came alive with real emotions. It was like they were still living, in the present, within the heart of the oral historian. At times, tears would flow when the telling of historic events became horrific. there's a living connection between the oral historian and their ancestors. Lynn Little Bear appears to have a strong connection with his late father, Chief Daniel Webster, Little Eagle Custalow. One time, when we were talking, Lynn Little Bear appeared to transform into the late chief, Little Eagle. Lynn Little Bear assumed the facial features and body stance of his late father. As Lynn Little Bear repositioned himself in the chair, I sat silently, not letting on to what my eyes beheld. Finally, I broke the silence, stating, "The purpose of history, it has been said, is to learn from history, but it does not seem as though it is put into practice very often." Quickly, Lynn Little Bear responded, "We can only learn from the real history. Many don't see the real history. The reason we have not learned from history is because we have not embraced the truth of what has happened." Angela L. Daniel, Silver Star, College of William and Mary, Department of Anthropology, PhD Program, Williamsburg, Virginia. Introduction. How to tell the story. Our concern in writing down the oral history of our people was to find a way to keep the content and sequence of events and still convey the rhythm and power of speech. We have chosen to include in this book many of the actual words and sentences as spoken by Dr. Linwood Little Bear Custalow, the oral historian of the Mattaponi Tribe. The Mattaponi Tribe of Virginia is one of the few remaining tribes of the great Powhatan nation that the English colonists encountered during their establishment of Jamestown. Along with the Pamunkey tribe, the Mattaponi tribe was one of the first six original core tribes forming the Powhatan nation. The four other core Powhatan tribes were Appomattox, Arawak, Yattanamand, and Powhatan. The Powhatan nation included over 30 tribes before its collapse. The Mattaponi tribe is one of the last two remaining of the six original tribes that form the Powhatan nation, who reside on one of the only two reservations in Virginia. The other tribes that enlarged the Powhatan nation came in by alliance. The narrative of the book is true to its oral history. Its language and structure is designed for our eyes as well as our ears. Between the more relaxed format of the spoken word and the more formalized structure of the written language that together compose this book, we hope you will be able to take this story into your heart as well as your mind. Part 1. Teach the full Indian history. That is the problem today. Too much Indian First American history has been left out. Mattaponi Tribal Member. Chapter 1. Pocahontas, A Favorite Child. The story of Pocahontas is first and foremost a great love story. The love that was the moving force within Pocahontas's life was the spiritual bond and filial affection between Pocahontas and her father, Chief Powhatan Wahasinaka, and the love they had for the Powhatan people. Wahasinaka was the paramount chief of the Powhatan nation. Pocahontas and Wahasinaka's father-daughter relationship was so strong that even the English colonists recognized that Pocahontas was the favorite child of the paramount chief. What the English colonists did not know was why Pocahontas was held so dearly in the hearts of this paramount chief. After all, Wahasinaka had many children. Customs were different in 17th century Powhatan culture. Being the paramount chief of the Powhatan chiefdom, called Sinakamaka, Wahasinaka married young maidens from each of the tribes within the alliance. The tradition was to infuse all the tribes with blood from the primary leader and to provide relational ties and obligations throughout the chiefdom to unite the tribes under one paramount leader and enlarge the Powhatan nation. It was a great honor for a young woman to be asked by her tribe to be taken in marriage with a paramount chief. She could decline if she so desired. Women were not forced into marriage, not even with the paramount chief. However, this was considered not only a great honor, but it provided the women with a great deal of political and social clout. Few would have declined the opportunity. If a woman refused, the position would have been filled quickly by a woman who was agreeable to the arrangement. These were alliance marriages, not marriages of love, but of politics and agreement. Love marriages were more permanent. An alliance marriage was meant to seal the alliance between the Powhatan nation and the incoming tribe. It was a temporary marriage in order to infuse royal blood into the alliance tribe and to establish kinship ties. This custom was limited to the paramount chief of the Powhatan nation. After the alliance wife gave birth, she had the choice of living in Werowocomoco, the secular capital village of the Powhatan nation, or returning to her village. Due to the prestigious nature of this position in Powhatan society, the alliance wife would have had no difficulty in finding a real husband. Instead, she would have been highly sought after for marriage. She would have been highly esteemed. The mother of little Pocahontas was Waha Seneca's first wife. Her name was also Pocahontas. They were married before he became the paramount chief. The mother of little Pocahontas was his wife of choice, the wife of love to Waha Seneca. The marriages to the young maidens from the alliance tribes held more of a sense of responsibility and obligation to the welfare of Senecamaca, the entire chiefdom. The mother of little Pocahontas was his wife of love, not of compliance to customs. Therefore, Pocahontas's mother held a special place in Waha Seneca's heart. Sadly, Pocahontas's mother died while giving birth to Pocahontas. Waha Seneca was devastated. Overcome with grief, he found a spiritual connection to his lost wife in their child. Little Pocahontas was given the name Matoaka at birth. Matoaka translates as flower between two streams. The name was most likely given to her because the Mattaponi village was located between the Mattaponi and the Pamunkey York Rivers. Matoaka's parents were from the Mattaponi and Pamunkey tribes. Her mother was Mattaponi. Her father was Pamunkey. It is interesting that later in life, Pocahontas became the Powhatan symbol of peace between two vastly different cultures, the Powhatan and the English, by obeying her father's will. When the woman of his heart died, Matoaka was all Waha Seneca had remaining of the woman he had cherished. Due to Waha Seneca's great love for his beloved wife, he often called his daughter, Pocahontas, after her mother, for her mother's name was Pocahontas. Pocahontas means laughing and joyous one. There was no question that Pocahontas was his favorite child. It is as if he said to himself, "I really have to go all out and love this baby because I lost everything I had to get her." It was that type of love. If the baby had been a boy, he would have been a special boy. But it was more special because Pocahontas was a female. She resembled her mother, making Waha Seneca especially caring as a father. Waha Seneca decided that it would be better for little Pocahontas to be nurtured by the women in the Mattaponi tribe than at Werowocomoco. The people of the Mattaponi village were her closest relatives, and they would give her special attention and tender care because she was a part of them. Little Pocahontas needed breast milk. Her aunts and cousins, who were nursing, were more than willing to nurture little Pocahontas. They had a special love for her. In essence, Waha Seneca felt like they would nurture little Pocahontas as their own child. It was the way of the Powhatan people to care for those in need, such as the elderly, widows, and orphans. To take in a relative in need when unquestioned, so the baby was welcomed with enthusiasm and love. Instead of one mother, Pocahontas had many. As the women of the tribe.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.